there are a few prerequisites before you actually do this. So the first one is to have a desktop application ready. So you can download from this particular link based on the platform you're using. And I've already downloaded it, and I have MetaTrader ready with me. And this is how the MetaTrader desktop application looks like. And the second one, you need to install Python, and that you can, this particular notebook or the document will be shared with you so that you can also explore these links. So you need to install Python since we are coding with Python. And once you install Python, you need to install MetaTrader. So these are the basic prerequisites you would need in terms of installations. And once you've gone through these installations, you need to open a demo account and get the login credentials. So I'm going to show how that is done. So once you open your desktop platform, you can click on accounts, and you can right click and click on open an account. So this is how you can open an account. You can go to navigator, accounts, and open an account. And by default, MetaCourse Limited will be selected. You can proceed with that. And post this, you can either open a demo account or a real account, but let's go with the demo account so that we can explore this. And with the demo account, you can fill these details: your first name, last name, email ID, mobile number, etc. And you can also select this option. So if you select this option, you would have hedging. So I'm sure most of you know what hedging is. Basically, you would have margin account, and you can take advantage of leverage. So you just need to fill these basic details and click on agreement, and post that your account will be created instantly. So you can copy the registration information to the clipboard, and using this, we will proceed our demo now. So as you could see, I have pasted the same information, the login information like that was just created, which are these. So a login account for login and a password. So this is the demo account I created, and you can also create it instantly. So let's move ahead. And let's go through all the steps we have discussed so far and see how it is done in live. So the very first step for any kind of automation, be it MT5, be it MetaTrader, I'm sorry, be it Interactive Brokers, or be it Amy Broker, or Jirodha, or Alpaca, anything. So the first step you do is to establish connection. But before that, get the documentation handy. It's a very good habit to at least go through the documentation and understand what kind of functions we have. And as you could see, this is the documentation of MT5, like Python MetaTrader 5. And there are certain functions. For example, there is a function called initialize, which is used to establish a connection with MetaTrader terminal. So like that, there are functions for every action you would have to take. And we would use the functions that are there from this particular link. And as we move forward, I'm going to show them also and the practically. So the very first step is to establish a connection. So for that, we are going to use the same login ID and password we got by registering the account. And we would just use an initialize method. So the very method we have seen from the documentation, the initialize. So using this, by giving the details, as you could see, the initialization is successful. So what if I give a wrong password, it would give me a initialized failed message, and also it get an audible notification also. But once I give the right password, right details, as you could see a chime, and also the message is initialization successful. So in general, this is what we do when we are manually trading. And when we are manually trading, we would enter into our platform, be it web-based or offline. We would enter our login ID and password. And once the authorization happens, then we would move forward. And as a natural step, we would want to check how much money we have in our accounts and if we have any positions open. So that's what you can do by using the method account info. So there is this function account info that is already built. Since we are using this Python wrapper, which is an official Python wrapper by MetaTrader, that's the reason the name is MetaTrader 5. And since we are using that, we can use the methods that are already there. By using the account info method, by running this code, you can get the current information. See, currently I'm not holding any position, so profit is zero, and I have $99,996.88 in equity, and there is no amount that is held for margin, and entire amount is free. So I can see the same thing here as well. If I go to the platform, I can see the same thing. The current balance is this, which is exactly what we have seen here. And also free margin. I have almost all, in fact, entire amount, entire balance is free from margin. So we have done the very basic steps that we do even in automated manual trading. So the next step is to get the data. Here is an interesting part. So when we are doing manually, there is 1 minute data which we are used to, 15 minute data, daily data, etc. But programmatically, we can resample into any data we want. Like you can get the data, like 1 minute data, and resample it to, let's say, 5 minute, 20 minute, 30 minute, etc. But interestingly, with the Python wrappers, they give you many options. For example, there is a method called copy rates from. So this is the method you use to get data, but it needs certain input, right? It needs certain information to get the data. So the very first information is symbol. Even when you're manually trading and if you're searching for a chart, the first thing you input is the symbol. So let's try for Euro AUD, Australian dollar, and the time frame. What data, what frequency of data you want? If it is daily data, you can use this method. If it is hourly, you can use this method. And there are methods for many time frames. So let's use daily and end time. So in general, end time would be, you can define an end time. So currently the end time is defined as the current time and how far into the history you want, I mean, how many data points you want. For example, if I give the time frames as daily, and if I give end data as 20, I would get the past 20 days information. Let's see how it works. So I have run this code, and as you could see, there is some information I got in the form of an array, and this is not clear. In fact, I could see the first data type is time, but this is not clear. This is in the form of Unix. And the second one is open price, then the high, low, close, tick volume. But anyway, this is not clear for me because this is just in a form of an array. So we have created a function. You can directly use this function and get the same data. So let me get daily data. So you can use the same function that is created in the name of fetch forex data, and I've just used that function, and that function also uses the method that is there in the documentation. It's just that I've taken care of the conversion of the time, which comes in Unix format. We have changed into daytime format so that we can understand. We also define the time zone. Currently US Eastern time zone is defined. So now it is much clearer. So we got the same information, but it's just that the data is clear now. And currently, let's just check for same, yes. So I was checking for Euro AUD with this particular method, and we got this information in the form of array. Now we have used this custom function created, and then got the information for the same symbol. And now it is more structured. Now I can clearly see what date and time the data is, data belongs to, which is open, high, low, close, and volume two. So you can get data of other contracts also. For example, if you go to MetaTrader platform, you can see some contracts here. For example, GBP USD. I can also search for GBP USD, and I get the information. But this is daily. I can also get 1 minute data. As you could see, this is 1 minute data now. This is live data, and this is data for today, and this is live. And in fact, interestingly, I can get 10 minute data, 12 minute, 2 minute, 20 minute. There are lots of methods that are available. This is a common feature for all the Python wrappers, and you can get any kind of data. You can choose the time frames you want, and accordingly you can get the data. So naturally, once you get the data, the next, please don't mind this chimes. So that is from the trading platform, since we are just connected. So once you get the data, you can also get the tick data. I'm not going over tick data now. You can explore this once you get hold of this particular document. But let's go to the important part, which is defining a trading logic and generating trading signals. So this is the reason why we automate, right? So let's understand that. So you can see, this is the place where last time when I launched a poll, 70% of the people have said they have already explored, like they don't want to explore strategies now. They don't have a strategy ready, but they want to focus on automation. And 30% have already had strategies. So this is the place where you make most of the difference or most of the impact. And so because the entire profitability depends on the strategy you pick. But as of now, for this demo, I'm showing you an example strategy. And let's take an example strategy that is quite understandable by most of you guys, which is a moving average crossover. So I've taken pretty arbitrary numbers like 5 and 10. And I would want to generate trading signals based on moving average 5 and moving average 10. And based on the crossover, if the 5 moving average is greater than 10 moving average, I want to buy. And in other case, I would want to sell. So this is the basic strategy I've written. And as we move forward into the webinar, we would also see how to get hold of other strategies too. And as you could see, I've used the same methods that we discussed so far. I've used this particular function to get the data and just calculated the moving averages and generated a signal. For example, if I run this, you can see I've generated a sell signal. So essentially, it generates a sell signal when 5 moving averages above 10 moving averages. That's what happened here. But we don't stop here. Let's also place some orders. So understanding trading logic and generating signals is not where we stop, but we do place orders too. You can place orders very easily. There are, if you go to documentation, you can see several methods that can help you to place orders. So you can see here how to place orders. But let's, we have created a function for you because to place orders, you need lots of information. You, even when you're manually trading, you would place an order by place by giving an information of the symbol, number of lots you want to trade, and whether the order type is buy or sell, and do you want at what price you want to trade, and etc. etc. So this function takes care of all the default methods that should be filled, and you just need to give the symbol and the lot. So that's how there are two functions that were built for you for your practice, which is place buy order, place sell order. So you can practice with this. I would also show you how it is done. For example, so let us use the method buy place order, and let's give a symbol and let's give some size. So if I run this, now I could see a message saying order placed successfully and I've got an order ticket number. So I'm going to trading platform and I just want to check whether the order has been placed or not. And as you could see, the order number is this 150 and it ends with 748. And you can see the same order on the trading platform. And the order has been placed and that's a buy order. That's what we did. We placed a buy order for USD CHF. So let's try something. Let's place an order for, you guys can type it out. You guys can type it in the chat what forex symbol you want to. You can see euro USD GBP Great Britain pound USD USD CHF, like which is Swiss franc Japan. Let's place some order. Let me see the chat. You guys can type in the chat and let's try to place some orders and see if the platform is picking the orders or not. So people want the USD, okay, there are many things. Okay, yeah, the most recent one was Great Britain Pound USD. Okay, Mr. Ganesh want to see if he could do this. So let's see, you want GBP USD, right? So I guess 4 or 5 people wanted to see if he could place order. So Great Britain Pound USD, yes. So we have successfully placed order. So let's see, we have placed a buy order on Great Britain Pound and USD for a lot of 0.01. So we can see it here for the symbol GBP USD. We have placed an order just a moment ago, a buy order, and with a volume of 0.01. So this is how you place orders. So let's place one more order. Let's place a sell order. Let me go through the chat and see what other things. Okay, people want Euro USD, which is quite popular. So let's do we have a Euro USD already placed? No. So let's place a sell order for Euro USD now. Let's see. So order has been placed. Now we place a sell order. So you can see it's in red, which is a sell order, which is Euro USD just placed, and it's a sell order. So this is how we can place orders very easily using a Python wrapper. And this is not common. This is not only for MT5. This is common for all the trading platforms which provides Python wrapper. And we are going to see how it is done as we move forward. But why don't we use the strategy that we have, right? So far, we have a basic strategy, moving average crossover, which is generating a sell signal. So let's use this. So I've written some code. So I've written like, if this particular function, the strategy for this symbol gives a buy signal, then let's place a buy order. So we use the same methods that we tried out so far. Let's place a buy order. If the strategy gives you a sell signal, and then let's place a sell order. So I'm just, okay, I just ran it now. It is placing a sell order, and the ticket ID ends with 31. Yes, it is here. So there are orders that are continuously placed. If you want, you can also change the symbols and see how the orders are being placed. So I'm just going to this particular desktop platform to show you that the orders are placed on live, but you don't need to again and again open the desktop platform, right? So you can also monitor your positions by using this method called positions underscore get. So I'm running this code just to see how many positions I have. As you could see, I have four positions. And even if I go to my trading platforms, I could see I have four positions. And let's go through, see, let's run it again. And currently the profit is 0.2 and it's about 0.2. And it's quite dynamic and it's quite live. And I can actually go through entire information here, the symbols, same thing we placed here. So I can not only place orders, I can also do the things that I do in general when I am manually trading. This is what I do when I'm manually trading, and I'm sure others too, to go through their positions and see, I can do certain data analysis also on this. For example, I can, if I want to close all these positions, I can close one position after another. This is what we do generally, right? If you're manually trading, you might click on close and close one position after another. And you can also do it. We have provided a code for you to close existing positions. It's just a loop that goes through each row of this data. Currently, we have this data saved. Let me just run this and show you. So the data is shown, saved in the data frame data with four orders. So we can just write a for loop which goes through each order. And if the order is a buy order, it would place a sell order and close it. And if the order is a sell order, it would place a buy order and close it. So that what happens here, it is checking the positions from the data. And if the position is buy, it is placing a sell order to close the position. And if in other case, it is placing a buy order. So let's run this. And I've run this code. And you could see I got four messages that these four orders has been closed, have been closed. And these are the information of the orders that were used to close this position. So essentially, we should not have any orders now. As you could see, the orders are gone. Now we don't hold any position because we have closed the existing positions. So as you could see, if I monitor my positions now, it says no positions found. So this is how you can automate every step of the manual trading you do, and also could do it much faster and efficiently according to the way you code it. For example, you don't need to write this big loop. You can also close a single order too. Let's do this simple exercise. Let me go to your charts and pick up a contract that is widely asked to place an order. Okay, so again, Euro USD. Let me place a buy order and just see how the single order can be closed. So earlier we had no orders. Now I just placed a buy order for Euro USD. As you could see, I have a single order here. And let's see how to close this single order. So I can copy the order ticket number, and you can check this code, which is at very end of the notebook, which is close single position. So I can just give its order, the order ID of a single position. And if I run this code, you can see I can run it, run the single code. And now I could see position has been closed successfully with this order ticket. And if I go to the platform now, I'm left with no orders.